how you doing, guys? I'm Patrick here, and I'm with Ryan Bellamore. He's one of the game directors on the division, and I'm just going to do an interview with him, so let's go.
Now, first question is, to the fans who don't know what the game is, how would you explain the division to someone who's brand new?
That's a great question. I think the division was very hard to kind of put it, lump into the genre, but I would say it is the easiest way for someone who's brand new is that it's an online focus game that's third person, that is a Tom Clancy game, so you can be ready to play with all of the classic Clancy components like squad-based combat, tactical, use of covers, and also having a high-tech level. In this scenario where you're sent to New York that's been hit by a deadly virus, and you are kind of the last resort before things fall apart.
Okay, cool.
Alright, so I got a Twitter machine for Broken Statue.
Broken Statue.
Yes. Will you be able to buy Soul Train NPCs, or is it only available in social ones?
You will definitely be able to buy, sell, and trade with NPCs in certain areas. Social zones included in that.
Okay, cool. Another question. Are we able to talk to civilians and get missions from them? Either by making choices and stuff like that?
Yeah. We really try to stress with, you saw the devil inside, the game is very, very much about choice and having in-game missions, but of course we also want you to have these connections to the people that you're kind of saving in this situation in New York. So there will be instances where you do have missions, if you will, from NPCs or civilians.
So what actually inspired you guys to make the division? Like, was there something you know they saw and I think got special from that? How did you guys come up with asking for it?
It's a couple years back now, I think 2.5, where we really had the kind of the mandate to kind of mesh Clancy and like an online RPG game.
Yep.
And so working with the creative director, it was basically how can we create a new Clancy unit that fits into the spectrum of Clancy games where you have Ghost Recon, Splinter Cell, Rainbow Six, doesn't step on anybody's toes. And we kind of came up with the concept that, well, to be different, the bad thing needs to already have happened. So we're not going in to assassinate the leader of a terrorist organization or surgically strike across the national borders. This is a homeland that is responding to something. So that was the kind of concept that we really fell in love with, across a lot of different mediums, the idea of this dystopian society, the fragility of society that's falling apart. And the whole idea that I'm kind of from that.
So why did you guys come to
there was a lot of talk about to set up once we had the IP and the setting we wanted, and really New York is just such a good choice because it's so iconic. So if you're from Sydney or if you're from Tokyo or if you're from the States, everyone has an image of New York. So to be able to create this kind of mid-crisis scenario, we needed to be able to very quickly help people recognize an area like Times Square and see that something is wrong. So seeing this mid-crisis scenario in an iconic choice was kind of a no-brainer. And on top of that, with our scenario, a virus being released, New York is one of the most traveled destinations. So extremely dangerous for people leaving right away.
So as we saw a few of them as a character consultation that you had in there, how big would that be once the engine looks like? What kind of stuff do you customize with character?
Sure. So we kind of categorize the gear that you get into two classifications. There's vanity stuff, and then there's actual gear which has statistics. So the vanity slots would be pretty much unlimited. Your caps, the beanies that you see the agents wearing, your pants, and all the shoes, and then there'll be set gear pieces that you can upgrade to find the world.
Yep.
So you want a lot of customization. We want you to be spending a lot of time with your agent in the game. Yep. That's a really good, strong connection where you can kind of make your representations of how you want.
So as we saw in the professional demos, you guys had a drive.
Yeah.
Can you just explain what was this
as a member we've seen before, you know, what, how it'll work, you know,
So the drone is it's basically like the simplest way for someone who has a common process. It's another member of your group. So you have players playing on their Xbox One or their PS4 or their PC, and you can, from the couch or even with a internet connection, join up with your friends and play as a kind of a positive buff, like for your squad. So you can mark targets, you can find sometimes new caches, you can drive enemies out of cover. It's just always a kind of a positive thing to them.
Okay, cool. So for those who also haven't seen the demo yet, they should be checking today. And also, I think GameStop is probably sitting here. Are you able to really explain, like, you know, maybe setting the film if you can?
Sure. Well, the demo that we are showing on Thursday, it's to highlight some more specifics in the gameplay from the Microsoft main stage demo. But it's also to actually kind of highlight the importance of time of day in the game. So these types of games that are online, and whether they're persistent or phased or whatever, having a time of day that is consistent among players usually doesn't actually affect the content. So the big first thing is we want to show the same area of Madison Square Garden at night and take you through a mission, kind of a sneak peek at a few agents in the drone, like you saw, and completing a mission in that center in Madison Square Garden.
So what would you say, so far in the department, what are you most proud of with the division? And what's the most important fear for the players?
Two good questions. For me, the thing I'm really happiest with is how we're handling player versus player. So Dark Souls, really taking the PvP to the core experience of our players, and really trying to push and reward people for building an experience in that content. And then I would say the thing that I'm making sure that we really focus on for our players is having enough things to do when you've taken back home. So when you're maximum level, what do I do? What draws me back into the game? What can I play endlessly theoretically?
Well, one question I've heard from a lot of Australian fans is servers. Are you guys going to be probably having dedicated Australian servers and sort of like a Destiny thing that they'll launch? Do you guys have any plans for that?
Yeah, I mean, it's a great question for Australians. I'm experiencing your pain down here with the internet. The logistics of how we're doing our mobile services, we'll come up with that later.
Fair enough, of course. As we always say, how many people can play at a time in a squad? How many people can play
in a squad? Yes. Okay, so a squad is 4 players, 4 agents, plus the drone.
Yeah.
So 4-point drone. And then you don't really have a limit yet on social awareness. That'll come closer to one.
And as we saw, at the beginning of this show for the first time, can you just explain more about that and how that will work?
And they are what we call elite or content in the game. So the you don't have to engage them. They're definitely benign, but if you get too close, or if you want to try to take them on for the potential reward, you can.
Okay. So when it comes to New York, just, it's a big area, obviously. Yeah. How do you guys plan on for the agents to travel? Is it fast travel? Obviously, I know that there's going to be no driving cars. So how would that work exactly if agents want to travel around the entire New York? Like,
good question, but it's another one that we're not going to specifics on.
No problem.
It could potentially be a reward for
Okay. So for the division, we noticed the skill tree system.
Yeah.
Can you also just go into more detail about that? Like, you know, where you had like the Sigma line and that kind of stuff.
Sure. So the way the skills work in the game is we really want a true plasticity system. So you have a base functional for a skill, and then as you gain experience in the game, you progression, you'll be able to actually modify those skills. And some of them do, there's actually layers of small, medium, and large modifications, and they do things like change the damage type, change the rate of fire for all the turret forces, up to a large modification, which might change the turret to flight damage, like you see in the fall demo, or make it still do a wall. Really change up the functionality. So that way you can adapt on the fly to either an enemy or a kind of combat scenario, or if both of us are playing with similar loadouts and skills, it can be a little different by modifying our skills.
So
can you hit me with one more? And then pick your winner. Yeah.
Pick my winner? Okay.
So I have to bail, yeah.
Okay, so when can we expect this game to release and what platforms, I guess?
Alright, that's great. So we're going to be out in 2015. I know everybody's waiting, trust me, we're brewing it, but we're going to be out on Xbox One, PS4, and PC.
Awesome. Where can they find you on social media if they want to follow you?
It's, the Division's on Facebook, we're on Twitter, we're on Reddit.
Awesome. Thank you very much for your time.
Yeah, good job.
Thank you.